Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk, just zone out with your camera. That was truly...
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room.
How do you know? Victoria Chase.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Would Dana do that?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria?
Dana's not a cheerleader at heart.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did.
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth. Answer, you wuss.
Dana's still a cheerleader at heart.
Leave me alone, Max. Get a clue.
Could be fun. Thanks for the warning.
Looks like nobody won this TV war. There's nothing left but ghosts. At least that's an alarm from this century.
At least that's an alarm from this century.
Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break.
Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break. That's real nice, Victoria. And who the hell thinks I'm a hipster? Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure.
Maybe I will join her posse.
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse. I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Juliet, read this.
I'm an asshole.
Of course.
I'm sorry, Dana. You are. And I hope so. You really think
I'm an asshole.
Zachary?
I'm sorry, Dana.
When I get stupid jealous,
you are.
I owe you.
And I hope so.
Still love me?
You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No.
But I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max.
Thank you.
You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Must protect my precious, so Max never has to chase it down again.
Hey, Dana. Seriously, thanks again.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Poor Juliet gets her rage on.
I hope she doesn't kill Victoria. Zachary should worry, too. As if I'd let that ego case jockstrap touch me. But I bet Victoria would be all over that action. Or has been. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy.
A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
I gotcha.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the party poster.
Not that I would open it no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect.
Cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. It's so fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And, yes, Max,
of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. So fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And, yes, Max, so terribly wrong. I better rewind. Ouch, poor Alyssa. That'll leave a bruise.
Move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying? I cover the waterfront, so you better figure out what side you're on.
Leave me alone.
Thanks again. Let's talk later.
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Matt.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone. Hope you enjoyed the show.
Hey,
thanks for nothing,
is
Max.
Bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem.
I should have stepped in between Kate and David. That asshole was so over the line. I could rewind and try something different.
Oh, well, Max, that was great. I think you scared for one.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business.
I can't stand to see people being bullied. I don't get it. How could Zach and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Mac. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way.
Better than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria at that joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Max, how are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
I don't get it. How could Zach and Victoria do that to me?
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter.
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Mac. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie?
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
No worries, Warren. I took a sweet shot of Victoria I can't wait to share.
Oh, score one for Team Max. It would be so karmic to see her ass clown face all over the interwebs.
I guess she does deserve it for all the shitty things she's done to people here.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
For a week, I did browse through all the titles, Drama Queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white, plus babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new, I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me, worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Everyone tries, though.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh, man. You're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
Wait
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
And an asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max. Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate. So, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy-flippin' morons and watch them twitch into a DJ dance death rattle. Take a photo of that. So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. We had such a blast drawing these together. It reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
Hey, did you find the disc yet?
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
I know my room is a disaster, but you can find a disc.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. This postcard is from Rachel Ember. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. I'm not into them. Too pretentious. Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play. I think this junk swallowed her discs. She looks super happy. She looks super stoned. She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned. Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop. But I love how funky and outdated it is. She even covered it in punk stickers because Chloe doesn't give a shit. Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
So, who is she? Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Amber. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
So, Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing. I assume you know more than that. Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Let's hear that CD.
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret. She looks super happy. She looks super sad.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
See anything.
15 kids in the backyard drinking wine. You tell me stories of the sea. And the ones you left behind. Goodbye to the roses on your.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Nope, someone locked it from the other side. This is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
I'm singing songs about the future. Wondering where you are.
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. I should be able to find the tools I need here. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. What's in those files up there? Shit! Butterfingers! Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. Cool, now it's opened. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Nothing. This is so lame. Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Yes! Score. Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. Poor little dear. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. Poor little dear. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years.
Little pieces of time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay, I'm in class. Everything's cool. I'm okay.
Light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream. Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Let's see. The tools are stuck, out of reach, and no way in hell to get them. Brilliant. That does not look stable. Let's see. The tools are stuck, out of reach, and no way in hell to get them. Brilliant, Max. Brilliant.
Fully haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right?
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here. Plus, it's perfect for my portfolio. And I have to get my daily selfie, Clara.
You in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Thank you. like that to me.
Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Booyah, you skank. Karma's a bitch. Nice framing, too.
Wait, I've seen this before.
No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.